Raheem is 9 years old. He was born premature. He's a fun, loving, little interactive child. Have a seat. That has an extensive medical history. Most can pertaining to his seizures with the hydrocephalus, which is, you know, the water on the brain and around the brain area. With the seizures, there's really no preset plan of when the seizure will come upon or when they won't. So pretty much we just go throughout our daily lives as anyone else would. And we just try to keep a close eye on him. You know, we see anything, any type of changes in his behavior, if it's from him crying more or if it's just from him being very restless, for us to, you know, trigger into it maybe a seizure about to come on, and a way we can detect it sooner. As of right now, only thing that we really can tell is just his tiredness, when he's really exhausted from long days. Other than that, we've not had a true diagnosis of what causes his seizures. In reference to the service dog, it would be a seizure detective dog. So it will help us. It will alert us moments and hopefully, when I say moments, by minutes before he actually has a seizure. Well, we are under the understanding that once we get to our goal range is when they'll start to, you know, the production of the service dog. And I'm not sure the complete turnaround, but I know our best of hopes and wishes right now is at least before middle of 2018, somewhere right around June or July is our hope. Well, we're really hoping that it becomes him a more sociable child. I mean, as of right now, he's pretty much sociable. I mean, he loves anybody that he comes around. But I've seen through other service dogs how it helps not just a child, but even adults with their social skills and behavior skills. And that's another thing that we struggle with when he's outside of the family area, that he does have the issues of being able to control his behavior. So that's our major goal of it, just the behavior and seizures.